October 5th, the first day of our tree season here in Pennsylvania. Had some great weather this morning. It was low 40s. It was hot this week, so the temperature dropped last night. Early on, and those two fawns come through, as you saw. They milled around in here for a while. Then they circled back around. They actually bedded down. And they bedded down for a long time. And I was kind of waiting on them to get up so I could get out of here. You saw them get up there. I had some footage of them leaving. They're working their way out the ridge now. Gonna get packed up here, head out, get some more lunch, and come back in here this evening. I don't know if I'm gonna be down here on the bottom or if I'm gonna go up on the other side of the hill here tonight. Gonna keep an eye on the wind, but we'll think about it over lunch though. Just getting back up here in the stand. I'm in the same spot I was this morning. Still pretty windy out. It's really gusting up there on the hill, so I figured I'd come back down here. I'm on this lower bench, so it's really not as windy down here. There's a heavy trail here about 15 yards to my left, so hoping they're coming out, working out of this thicket here. They'll go up to the cornfield about 200 yards up here behind me, and the wind's coming right at me, so the wind's not going to be an issue down here, but I don't know. It's still kind of blowing hard, so you can never tell, but fingers crossed. Love to get a deer finally down with this recurve, but time will tell.
might have been a little forward. I definitely poked out the other side though. They were in here. I don't know, my car's way over there. I don't know if they can see it or something, but like the glare off the windshield or something, but they were in here pounding their feet and I thought they were gonna go, and she came in here about, that was about 18 yards, and I thought that was gonna be the best chance I got before that they were gonna leave, and I let her have it, but wow. Oh. I thought I heard a crash, but I hope so. Well, it's kind of hard to tell watching the shot there on the little screen on the camcorder, but I mean, it looks good. I mean, I hugged that shoulder and the way she was quartering away, I think it's good, because when she ran away, I could see the arrow sticking out, but it passed through and it looked like it came out the other, right behind the shoulder on the other side. So fingers and toes crossed for this, but boy, am I excited. Man. She probably only went maybe 50 yards. Oh, here's my arrow. Oh, yeah. Cutthroat doing the job. 50 yards and recovery.
Well, thanks Lexi for coming out here and getting some footage and pictures of this. It's quite the experience here. Kind of lost her words. I hunted really hard last year. Had a lot of opportunities and just couldn't pull through. So this year I was pretty determined to get one, and here the first day archery in Pennsylvania, and was able to harvest my first doe with the Recurve. Yeah, it's unbelievable. I was shaking so much, and I went back and watched the footage in the tree, and you know, I thought I was a little forward, which I was, but the way she was quartering away, I came out right back on the back shoulder here, and she piled up within 50 yards of the tree stand, so that couldn't have worked any better, so.
Woo!